Hey ladies and gentlemen, Stephen here from Rattle Lessons and welcome back to another video. Thank you so much for joining me today. I really appreciate it and I hope that this video finds you well. In today's episode, we're going to be taking a closer look at what is arguably the best chocolate fragrance on the market. Is this the benchmark chocolate fragrance, the holy grail gourmand fragrance that everybody is looking for? This one by Montale is called Chocolate Greedy, so make sure to stay tuned. Now, before I begin my fragrance review of Chocolate Greedy by Montale, I do want to mention that if you are a fan of fragrance-related content, if you like fragrance reviews here on YouTube, but also top 10s, giveaways, unboxings, special guests, interviews, and pretty much anything having to do with fragrances, please do consider supporting this channel by subscribing to it. All you have to do is click on that red button in the corner. And of course, while you're at it, please be sure to enable notifications by clicking on the bell. This way, whenever I do put out these videos, they will get delivered straight to your feed. You never need to worry about missing any of my future uploads. So I know when it comes to chocolate fragrances, there are quite a few. There are designer chocolate fragrances like Bad Boy by Carolina Herrera. There's also this one and a number of others that really get our attention. However, this is the one that is often spoken about, and I know many people out there have gotten their nose on it. And it's the type of fragrance where the moment you smell it, you start salivating. It's such a delicious chocolate fragrance. I should also mention that if you are interested in picking this fragrance up, you may do so at kingdomfragrances.com. They were actually the ones that provided this bottle to me for review. So a very special thank you to Steve for sending this fragrance over to me. I really appreciate that, my friend. Definitely show him some love and support. I'm gonna be linking Kingdom Fragrances down below, and they actually have this fragrance for like the best price right now. It's somewhere in the $70 range, which is incredible for a Montale fragrance given the MSRP. But Chocolate Greedy, a fragrance that I once considered to be a bit of a novelty scent, I thought it was perhaps a little bit too strong on the chocolate, which it is, but I've definitely come around to love it just because it does something in such a dynamic way, in a unique way, and in a way that no other fragrance has managed to do, in even after years after it's been released. And so I'm really excited to tell you more about the smell, but let's start things off with the presentation. Now the box for this fragrance is quite simple. It just has the name of the fragrance towards the bottom here on the front. You have the serial number printed in white ink on the bottom of the box. And the rest of your information may be located on the back of the box, and this is Eau de Parfum Strength. On the inside of the box, you will find this pouch that the bottle comes in. And I'm sure you know that Montale bottles have this stopper here that you must remove prior to spraying the fragrance. Now keep in mind, it does come in this aluminum can and it's going to feel really light, but be rest assured, it is full to the top and this is the 100 ml size. The distribution on the atomizer is nice and wide. Let's continue with the smell. So as soon as this fragrance opens up, you are going to get that dusty, powdery, chocolatey goodness. It's so warm and velvety and rich and gourmandy, and I love the way that this one smells. Again, I want to reiterate, when I first tried this one, I wasn't the biggest fan of it. I thought it was a delicious fragrance from the onset, but I thought that it was a bit too much of a novelty scent in the sense of, I thought to myself, when am I going to wear this one? And I think that that was my biggest challenge. I wanted to purchase it. I wanted to get my hands on it. I just couldn't justify or rationalize when I was going to wear it. And I think now I've just gotten to a point where I say, I don't care. You know, I'm just gonna wear it whenever I want. If I like the way that it smells, I'm going to purchase it, I'm going to acquire it, I'm gonna find some means to get my hands on it. And so I am certainly very thankful to have this one in my collection, but it opens up with this beautiful chocolate note. And it kind of has like this hazelnut vibe in here. It's funny because hazelnut is not listed as a note, but it has that chocolatey warmth and that dusty powdery thing going on in the opening. There is bitter orange, and there is a little bit of a citrusy twinge in the opening, if you will, but there's this vanillic undercurrent with accents of coffee. Now, it's interesting because when you think of coffee and you think Montale, chances are you're thinking of Intense Cafe or Ristretto Intense Cafe, and those are definitely very heavy-handed on the coffee. In this fragrance, however, it doesn't smell like a cappuccino or anything like that, where I'm not really getting that coffee note, but I am definitely getting the chocolate. And it reminds me of one of those Ferrero Rocher chocolates. I hope I'm not mispronouncing the name, but they have the gold foil, you know, wrapping on them, and so delicious, right? And so it immediately puts me in that mindset. It's so realistic. And if somebody were to spray this on a test strip like I just did here, and they put it underneath your nose, but you were blindfolded and you couldn't see what you were smelling, you would be 100% convinced that you are smelling some sort of a chocolate dessert. I don't know if I would say tiramisu. It doesn't have some of the sweeter nuances that are, you know, attributed to the smell of tiramisu. However, I do get this beautiful gourmand richness from it, and it is definitely the best chocolate fragrance on the market, bar none. No other fragrance can hold a candle to this one. Let's go ahead and finish things off with my overall assessment. So first up, in terms of the uniqueness and the overall smell, there are a lot of other gourmand fragrances on the market, especially other fragrances either from the same brand or a sister company like Mancera that utilizes some similar ingredients. Like, I know there's also Roses and Chocolate by Mancera, which also has a chocolatey vibe. And then there's also Ferragamo Uomo, which kind of has that tiramisu vibe, kind of putting it in the wheelhouse of this one, but still quite different. But despite all of the comparisons that I made, this one still smells unique. If you are a fan of chocolate, and I know there's also Sorriso by Profumum Roma, that is another delicious chocolate fragrance. However, that does things a little bit differently. But this one is a holy grail chocolate fragrance. If you are a fan of gourmands, this is one that must be checked out. This is just the epitome of gourmand, and I think it's gourmand done very well in the niche industry. In terms of the longevity, you can expect about 7 hours on your skin. The projection for this one is very good for the first 2 hours. It does have that orangey quality about it, like I said, and I think that that really helps you know, the fragrance to project quite well in the opening. And then after that 2 hour mark, it doesn't become an elbow length scent until that 5 hour mark. And so you're dealing with pretty good longevity and pretty good projection. And again, it didn't become a skin scent until about that 7 hour mark, which is when I really felt the need to reapply, but it'll definitely get you through a work day if for some reason you're planning on wearing this one to work. In terms of the versatility, I think it's a little compromised because I think there will be some other people out there that find this to be a bit of a novelty scent, especially if they're used to wearing Bleu de Chanel and Acqua di Gio and Dior Sauvage. Then they're gonna smell this and they're gonna say, what the heck, right? It's so different. It's such a change of pace. And even in a way, it might be a little avant-garde in the way that it utilizes chocolate in such a strong way, but I find that this one is good for the colder weather. This is more of a playful scent, so not one to be taken too seriously. It's very jovial and lighthearted, and I do find this one to be perfectly unisex because, hey, chocolate is consumed by both men and women, right? In terms of the presentation, rather simple. One of the less interesting bottles by Montal because it's so simple, but in any case, you know, the presentation doesn't matter as much as the smell does. And so my final verdict on this fragrance is, I know I've said it before, I can't enumerate how much I really feel this is the epitome of a gourmand fragrance. It's a holy grail chocolate fragrance and is definitely a chocolate lover's dream. If you haven't tried this one and you're a fan of the smell of chocolate, what are you waiting for, right? Chocolate Greedy is the fragrance to check out. And so thank you all so much for tuning in. I really do appreciate it. I hope you enjoyed my review of Chocolate Greedy by Montal. Again, if you are interested in picking up this fragrance for possibly the best price that you'll be able to find it at online, you may pick this one up at kingdomfragrances.com. I'm gonna be leaving all of their information down below. And of course, if you are interested in seeing more videos like this on the Rettle Essence channel, please do consider supporting this channel by subscribing to it. All you have to do is click on that red button in the corner. And of course, while you're at it, please be sure to enable notifications by clicking on the bell. Thanks again for tuning in. Love you guys, and we'll see you soon. Bye.